active and you have to go to sleep, you know.
Right, right. And you might be receiving like some voicemail at 4 a.m. that you'll have to play in your next show.
Hey, there you go. Good for you. Well, Vince Inzunza from Pacific North Weird, tell people how they can get a hold of your channel on YouTube and on the internet so they can watch your videos of your travels out there for Pacific North Weird.
Yeah, you should definitely go to PacificNorthWeird.com, and that will lead you directly to our YouTube channel. You can subscribe to get updates. You can look through our 4 years worth of various videos and documentaries and music videos and all kinds of short videos and films that we've done documenting strange things in the Northwest. And you can find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, all that good stuff.
Oh, yeah, and they have to check out my favorite Bigfoot music video, Biggie Got Foot. That is just an awesome song that you wrote and produced the music video for, and that's a classic. They got to check that out.
Yeah, that's the moment I became a hip-hop artist.
Yes, you did. Oh,
I
wonderful.
I hang out with Puff Daddy every day.
Yeah, you and Bobo Faye and all the gang, you know, so wonderful. Vince, thank you much for letting us bug you tonight, and thank you for calling in from the McMenamins Hotel down there in Centralia, Washington, and tell us about the any potential hauntings that happen to you tonight when we talk next week.
Oh, it's always a pleasure, Michael. Thank you.
And say hi to Sabrina. Say thank you for all of her input tonight. You guys be careful. Have a good time tonight.
You too. Thank you. Have a great night.
Yep.
Bye.
Wow. Well, there you go. That is a fascinating report from Vince Inzunza and Sabrina, who are spending the night at a haunted hotel downtown Centralia in the old town down there that from this hotel that used to be a basically a prohibition hotel, you know, with the alcohol being smuggled in. Yeah, probably snuggled in too, but smuggled in through the probably the basement and some of these tunnels that connect underground down there. We'll have to see what happens with both of them next week when we get a report on how it went at this haunted hotel. Well, okay. We are, gosh, this is wonderful. We've got a lot of time here for our main guest tonight is going to be Steven Myers. And we are going to really get in deep and drill down to the issue of the Great Pyramid and the Giza Plateau. And we are going to talk about all sorts of things that you probably didn't even understand initially about how this pyramid was built and what was the purpose of the pyramid to begin with. We are going to take a short break for commercials at the very top of the hour tonight, but we've got plenty of time to get started with Steven and kind of give you an introduction to this fascinating subject matter that we're going to talk about next. So, Steven, do you happen to be on right now? Hey, Steven, can you hear me? And if you can, put your phone off mute.
Yes.
There
yes,
you are.
I'm here and ready to go.
All right, buddy. Well, thank you for holding on, by the way, through Vince Inzunza's report. I don't know if you got to hear about his haunted hotel that he and his girlfriend Sabrina are staying in tonight. But it was a fascinating report.
Yes, I did. I listened to it, and very interesting, to say the least. I live in the Pacific Northwest as well, in southwestern Oregon, and I've actually been to that McMenamins up there in Centralia. So it's a wonderful place, to be sure.
Oh, so you've actually been up to the McMenamins up here. Have you actually been to McMenamins as well?
I actually have.
Yeah.
So, it's nice too. They do a brilliant job of repurposing older buildings and keep the charm and make them into wonderful establishments.
Yes. Yeah, they really do. And of course, they take over the entire building itself. And there is just a buzz of activity going on all the time there. They've got the beautiful bars in there. They've got food and restaurants in the buildings. And when you're laying in bed in these really beautiful refurbished rooms, you get a real feeling of history just laying there, rather than, you know, going to a new hotel, you know, that you just pull into right off the freeway. You know, you really don't get that feel of history when you're in, like you are at the McMinniman's hotels. So, yeah, thanks for giving that input for yourself, being from Southwest Oregon, huh? Interesting. Tell us a little bit about yourself initially, maybe where you grew up, went to school, and that kind of stuff first.
Well, I grew up in Los Angeles County, a small town called Lomita, California, near Torrance. And moved up to Oregon in here in the Pacific Northwest, in a small town, very small, near Coos Bay, Oregon. So we're in the beautiful Pacific Northwest, and love it here. Anyway, I am, for the most part, a pretty regular type of person, except for this pyramid stuff. But I have a technical background with electronics. I'm an amateur radio operator at the FCC commercial radio class license, the commercial class.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I have a very technical background in a number of areas, but I'm also interested in history. And if a person, you know, the history I'm interested in is like the technical aspects of history, like World War II. I'm interested in the range of a plane, how far it can fly, and the bomb load, and that type of stuff, more so than the generals and the politics and all of that. So if a person is interested in technology and also history, ultimately their focus will be on the Great Pyramid, because it's a highly technical structure, a 45-story tall skyscraper built in very ancient times. It was the tallest building in the world for at least 4,000 years. So,
just that statement in itself is astonishing, that a structure could be the tallest structure on the planet for 4,000 years. I mean,
yes.
for us to even think that, you know, we're thinking this country is, you know, a couple hundred years old, you know, basically developed from rural communities in that period of time to what we have now. But the idea being that for 4,000 years, that building was still standing, probably, you know, the tallest structure on the planet. We're going to get into that for sure. This is going to be a fascinating interview tonight with Steven Myers, folks. But first of all, Steven, I would really like to hear about, you said you were a real kind of like a technical guy as a kid. Were you that way as a child as well down there in California? Were you the kind of guy that would always have a walkie-talkie trying to take it apart and see how it works? Or how did you get started in that electronic kind of gadgetry?
Well, my father grew up on a farm, and in the Depression, he was born in 1919. My father was, and you know, and if you had something, you probably made it, or you got it from somebody else when it was broken, and you fixed it. And he was very handy person on a whole bunch of levels. I mean, he could weld and do woodworking, and he was a haggler, a buyer and seller. You know, he would go buy a car that wasn't running very well, fix it up and sell it. And, he was a wheeler and dealer in a number of areas, but one of the most self-sufficient people I've ever met, and I got that gene from him, the handiness, you know. I change my own oil in the car, that type of thing. And I, believe it or not, do my own plumbing work. And because I enjoy that type of thing. And I just enjoy being handy in a number of areas. But yeah, I would tear apart everything I could get my hands on. Like when the washing machine goes haywire, and then after I fix it, the bad part, I got to tear it apart and see what was wrong with it, that type of thing. And it's fun. I mean, it's one way to do things instead of watching, let's say, football or whatever.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that's fascinating. Do you remember the very first electronic device or mechanical device that you took apart as a kid?
I had a mechanical toy, a car. And I took it apart, and it didn't work when I got done with it. It was worse off well, after I finished with it.
was one of those spring loaded kind of things that you would turn the key and make the thing move?
It actually had a battery. But my older brother, he's quite technical in a number of areas, and in high school, I was one of those guys that was in the audiovisual, you know, with the projector type of thing. And
all that. I was an AV kid as well, junior high school.
Oh, yeah.
It was the best job you could get in school because you got to get out of class and go watch movies with
other people
in their different classrooms.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it was a kick. And our high school had a ham radio station, so I operated on it. And ultimately, like I say, I got an interest in the Great Pyramid, and went from there. And it has become a life quest, you know, much more than an interest, but quite—I don't know if I'd call it a hobby, but quite a fascination with how it was constructed and what its purpose was.
Well, and you, did your family move up here to Oregon? Is that how you ended up getting to Southwest Oregon, or did you go to school there, decide to go to college, or how'd you end up in this neck of the woods?
Well, my father, you know, we lived in suburbia or whatever you want to call it, but he was from a small, he was actually from Grand Junction, Colorado, you know, back in the Depression era.
Yeah.
And, you know, he said it was too hot in the summer and too cold in the winter. But up here, the weather is very mild, you know, near the Pacific Ocean and everything. And he liked it up here. It's beautiful. And we moved up as a family when I was still in high school. So it was quite a culture shock, to be honest with you.
Yeah,
it was a whole different world, you know. It was small school and everything, but and then, you know, went off to college, and anyway, married my high school sweetheart, that type of thing. We're still married, and she's it'll be 39 years on February the 14th, so
Oh, you got married on Valentine's Day. Are you kidding?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. No, I got married on Valentine's Day, yeah.
Already, yeah. That is just quite a track record here. Being an attorney myself for the last 30 years, I know the statistics are way out of whack when it comes to how long relationships end, and you are one of the more unique ones to be able to last that long. So congratulations to both of you, for sure.
I appreciate that. Yeah, we work at the marriage and everything, and obviously she's very tolerant, so that helps.
that helps, especially when your significant other is into big time, you know, the long ago history of the pyramids out there in Egypt.
Oh yeah,
that's fascinating.
I even drug her to Egypt. We went there a number of years ago now, but we did some on-site research. And it was quite a trip. So,
I'll bet. Oh, we're going to have to get into that for sure. Now, you said you went to college. You went to college in Oregon, or where'd you go?
Yes. Oregon here, went to college here, got a degree.
And
but,
would, what